Gradients are an amazing way to make your design look smoother and more elegant. A while ago, the only way to use gradients on sites was to create a gradient in a separate image on some graphics software. Nowadays, we can use pure CSS for that. Hello and welcome. Thank you for coming and joining me in this video. My name is Artur, and here at my channel, I'm challenging you with various web dev ideas. CSS gradients can be a cool alternative to flat backgrounds. Also, with some more advanced settings that I'm going to show you in this video, you will be able to create some fancy patterns. Let's jump right into the code. CSS gradients behave like backgrounds, so in order to add a gradient to an element, all I need to do is provide here a style. We will be styling inline so you can see everything right in the single place in the HTML code. I'm setting the background of this element exactly the same way as if you were adding a URL to an image, but instead the URL, I will provide here a function. Linear gradient. In its most basic form, it accepts two colors. I'll go with black and dark cyan. And here it is. We have a gradient already, it goes from top to bottom by default. Instead of the names of the colors, of course, I can provide here either decimal values, like here, red, or I can go with hexadecimal values. When I save, you can see the gradient is here. In this video, however, to keep things as simple as possible, I will be trying to use exclusively the named colors as here. By default, the gradient goes from top to bottom, but we can easily change that. In order to do that, we add a first parameter of the linear gradient function, and we can specify, for example, to make it zero turn. So now it goes from bottom to top. When I set it to a quarter of a turn, it goes from the left to right. So as you can probably guess, half a turn goes top to bottom, and 75 turn goes from right to left. Another option to control the direction of your gradient is to use sides or corners. So if I specify for this gradient to go to left, it goes from right to left. I can set it to go to top. So now it goes from bottom to top. Similarly, I can set it to right or to bottom. Also, we can put here corners. So I can make it to go to bottom right. So now it goes from the top left to bottom right. If you need more control on the direction of the gradient, you can always use degrees. If you set it to 0 degrees, it goes from bottom to top. And now when you add degrees, it rotates clockwise. So let's set it to 45 degrees. So it's going to top right. When I set it to 90 degrees, it should go from the left to right. Or I could, for example, set it to 120 degrees and it goes this way. If we want to go counterclockwise, of course, we can use minus. So minus 45 degrees and now it's going to the top left. Let's set this gradient to go back to right so we can see clearly what's happening. Also, I will actually change this color to dark cyan and this one to brown. So we see clearly what's going on in here. By default, you can see it is mixing those colors equally. So on the left, we have the dark cyan, on the right, we have brown, and somewhere in the middle is the mixing midpoint, but we can change it. Here is the default. I'm setting 50% between those two colors. Notice the commas in here. So there's a color, other color, and inside between them, we have where the midpoint, the hint where the midpoint should be. I can change it to 25% and now it's more to the left. Or I could change it to 75% and now the midpoint is on the right side. Okay, let's start from scratch. I'll remove those colors. I can provide more colors than two, of course. So let's go with black, cyan, which is lighter, and dark cyan, which we've already seen. And now my gradient has three colors. So that's black on the very left, dark cyan on the very right, and the pure cyan on the very middle. By default, the middle color is in the very middle, so it is something like that. I can provide the value explicitly in here, but also I could change where exactly this color should be. So instead of at a half, I can set it to 25%. Now the stripe of pure cyan color is at the 25% of the gradient. If I set it to 75%, you see it's on the right of my gradient. We can use this percentage value to control even more how our gradient looks. So for example, for this black color, I can set it that it starts at zero, but I want the black not to be a single stripe, but to be until 33% of my gradient. And here I have a huge field of black. The cyan I will reset for a moment to 50%, and the dark cyan I'm going to set to go from the very right up till like a third. So it is 100% minus 33, it's 67%. So now I have a field of dark cyan, I have a field of black, and here I have a little gradient. What I can do is actually copy this and paste, and I am going to change this 50% to the same that I have with this black. So that's 33. And this on the right, I'm going to change the same way as I have with the dark cyan, which is 67%. Now when I save, look, what I got is actually no gradient. I have just three stripes, which are very sharp. So you can use linear gradients to create patterns which aren't gradients at all. Here it looks like a kind of flag. Let's have some fun and try to reproduce a rainbow color. So I'm going to remove all those colors that I have here right now. And a rainbow has seven colors, and these include red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. And here is our rainbow. Now let's use the same trick that we did a moment ago to obtain sharp stripes. So for red, it's starting at zero, and I want it to be for 14%, because 100 by 7 is about 14. So what I'm going to do is on the left side, I'm going to add 14% and 14% and 14%, and on the right 14, 14, 14, and in the middle we have a little bit more. Okay, so red 14%, then orange starts at 14% as well. So here is the first sharp stripe. Now I will add here orange as well, but another 13%, so that's 28. So here is wider orange. And so now yellow, it starts at 28%, and we continue with yellow until 42%. So here's the yellow stripe. I can't see much, so I'm going to add here a new line, and let's go with green. Green starts at 42%, and this is going to be slightly wider, so green, I'm going to set it to 58%. Below we have blue, starts at 58%, and then we have also blue, and it goes another 14, that's 72%. No comma in here. Save. Almost there. So now indigo, it starts where blue ended, so 72%. And ends at another 14, that's 86%. And we end with violet at 86%. And look, our rainbow in here is now made of sharp stripes. All right, let's remove the rainbow from here. I'm going to show you something else. Apart from colors like red, we can provide here also a keyword called transparent. This created for us a gradient between red and transparent color. So this part on the very right is completely transparent. So if I had something behind this div element, I could see through. We can use hexadecimal values instead of those names to have even more alpha channel control. So the red is FF0000, And if I wanted, I could, for example, set it to be AA, so it is almost opaque, but a little bit transparent. And the transparent one I could set to FF00000, so the alpha channel is at zero, so it is transparent completely. Finally, we can use the CSS3 background layers feature to overlay one gradient over the other. I'll copy this, add here a comma, and paste, comma, and paste again. This one is red. This one I'm going to change to green, and here also green, and this one at the very bottom I'm going to change to blue. Well, right now it isn't something that I expected. What happened is each gradient overlaid one over the other exactly, but what I could do here is change this to be at the 0 degrees, the second one to be at 120 degrees, and the third one at 240 degrees. So they should spread equally, and voila, we have a nice gradient. Red goes from the very bottom to top, green goes from the top left corner, bottom right, and the blue goes from the top right to bottom left. And because they start quite opaque and end completely transparent, they mix in the middle very nicely. If we don't need to be so precise about at which degree exactly we want the color to start, we can use the names of the sides and corners. So this one I am changing to top. The other one I'm changing to bottom right. And the third one I'm changing to bottom left. And voila, it's almost the same. So here's the red, here's the green, and here is the blue one. Finally, I want to show you something really amazing. We will start with an image in here. So I'm going to remove all those gradients for now. And instead, I'm going to paste here a URL to an image from Pexels. When I save, I have here a mountainy image. What I really don't like in here is that's not full image. So I'm going to add here another property called background size, and I'll set it to cover. So now here's the full image. I have this guy looking at the mountains. I would like to make this picture a little bit more dramatic, give it a little more thrill. What I'm going to do is achieve that with a gradient. I'm going to add here a kind of mist. I'm going to add here a gradient as another layer of the background images. So let's add here linear gradient. This one will go from top to bottom and we'll have two colors. The first will be misty rose and the bottom I want it to be transparent. And look, we added here a kind of a fog. We can experiment with various colors in here. This is really reddish, but I practiced a lot and I think for this particular image misty rose works most natural and it looks really, really great. All right, I will remove all those things and show you something new. Let's go with another gradient. So background, linear gradient, and I will want this to go to right. I will start with black, then I will have dark cyan, and then I will have black again. So we've kind of seen this already. What I'm going to do is to squeeze it to the left. So this one will take only 10 pixels and this one in here will take another 10 pixels. So it's 20 pixels in total. And this way I got here a stripe. What I can use this stripe for is to obtain actually a kind of a pattern. Instead of linear gradient, I will change this function to a repeating option. So that's repeating linear gradient, and we have this nice stripy pattern in here. Of course, if I wanted, I can change those pixels to percents. Now the size of the stripes in here will scale along with the element. Finally, let's make those stripes sharp. So I'm starting with black, and then I'm setting this black to take 10% of the gradient. Then I have dark cyan, which starts at 10%, and I want it to go this way until it is 20%. And then I will remove the black, I don't need it anymore. And look, voila, we have two kinds of stripes, one after another. We are going to end this video with a bonus. I'm going to remove this element which we were styling so far, and instead we are going to style a logo. So let's add here a div, logo, and the logo needs an image. For images, I thought let's go with some Font Awesome icon. I've been browsing Font Awesome website and I like this ghost icon. It looks cool for a logo. So here we can copy SVG code. I will click it and it's already copied. And now I can simply paste it in here. So when I save, I have here this huge guy in here. Let's add some styling. I'll put the styles directly in the code. I know it's not perfect, but it's okay for our exercise. Let's add here styling for the logo. I'll add here a border so you see what we are going to do. 1 pixel solid white, it should be visible. So this is the width of my logo, and well, the ghost is too big. I want this ghost to, of course, be smaller. So here I will add the styling for the SVG. I'll set the height of it to 60%. Cool. Now I want this to go to the very middle. I had a separate video on how to center things. I showed you a few ways how to center things in an element. Here I will go with the grid one. So display grid and just place items center. And now the ghost is in the very middle. I want the logo to be round, not square. How to do that? Let's use the border radius for that. I'll set it to 50%, and this is a circle right now. Finally, let's add here a gradient. Background. Here we're using linear gradient. Let's go with two colors, dark cyan and black again. Almost, but I think it would look better if we change this direction. So we have black in here, dark cyan in here. So what I'm going to set right now is to go to top right. Nice. Final touches would be to make this ghost actually not black, but maybe white. In order to do that, we need to edit this Font Awesome icon a little. Here is the path with our ghost. I'm going to set the fill to white. And voila, this ghost is now white. For final touches, I'm going to add some shadows in here. Let's remove the border from here. Instead, we will add here a filter, drop shadow. I want the shadow to be at the very center of the image. I want it to be 5 pixels wide, and let's make it black. And here is the shadow. And actually, let's make the ghost a little bit 3D as well. Let's add the same filter for the ghost. And that's our logo. We've used SVG for the image and then pure CSS to create a gradient. And because of that gradient, this image doesn't look flat. It looks really 3D. I really hope you enjoyed this video and that this idea will help you use CSS linear gradients in your projects. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe. Please let me know in the comments down below what other ideas and challenges you would like to see here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.